Some of these ideas I took from Pinterest and just made them miniature, so I think you'll have a lot of fun with this. This is my collection of ribbon and lace. It's a bit overkill. I bought this on eBay in a lot, so I pretty much bought all of it at once. I actually had this idea that I would make dollhouse wedding dresses on dress forms. So I got the lace and I have the dress forms, but I lack the skill and patience to do that. So instead of just letting this lace languish, I'm gonna use it for something else. The first project I'll be doing is some books. So I'm taking some foam core and cutting it into book shapes and sizes. This is really easy, and I'm gonna cover it with this velvet I bought. I think I got it at Hobby Lobby, I'm not sure. So I just take my tacky glue and cover the foam core book, press it down. I never wait for things to dry. You probably should, but I'm just crazy impatient. So I just cut all of the extra off and had a little stack of books. These look cute just as they are, but I'm gonna take some cutouts from pieces of lace and embellish them with the little pieces I cut out. This was fun taking a look at the lace and figuring out what little pieces I could take out to embellish these books. You could use this little guy as a small scale doily, but I just covered it with some hot glue and slapped it on one of my velvet books. And then I have a really cool pile of little books, and these are so pretty and so classy, and I couldn't stop making these. I wanted to just keep doing this. But I had this plain little balsa box that needed some embellishment, so I decided to move on with my projects. The first thing I did was draw a line where the lid meets the base of the box. Because I'll be covering this in velvet as well, and I still want it to function. I cut out a rectangle and glued it to the top of the lid using some tacky glue. I'm applying some more tacky glue to the sides. I cut a strip of velvet and I made sure one of the edges was nice and straight so it would meet the top piece of velvet nice and tightly so it'll be neat and tidy. All of this excess I'm just cutting off. I didn't wait for the glue to dry when I started trimming it. I just trimmed it while it was all wet and nothing bad happened. So this project works well for people like me who are impatient and want instant gratification. I could have stopped here, but that's not my style. So I laid a little strip of hot glue and covered the edges with some more tacky glue. And I wanted a nice finished look, so I even added a piece for the bottom. I was looking through my lace pile, and I like the look of this lace, but it's too big because of the little fleur-de-lis pieces. So I modified my lace. So you can take your full-size lace and make it more appropriate for miniature scale by just doing some modifications. I took a couple of my fleur-de-lis pieces and hot glued them to the top. I wanted to have a little knob, so I poked a hole with a sewing needle into the lid of the box, and I took one of the glass ornaments I used in my Christmas tree video and put it on a straight pin used for sewing. And I attached it to the top of the box using some hot glue and just pushed it through the hole I had made. So with just a few minutes effort, I ended up with this really pretty little box. But wait, there's more. I have these vintage dollhouse pillows, and I wanted to take some inspiration from these and make some pillows of my own with a lace border. So I started by cutting a rectangle of fabric, and I didn't even measure this. I'm using some hot glue to sew my hems, my sides, for my pillow because I don't like to sew. And I filled it with some fiber fill. Took a little bit out because it was a bit too much. Closed this final seam with my hot glue. So there are three hot glued edges and one folded edge. Took my scissors and trimmed off the excess. And then I did it again, repeated this magic, so I could have a pair of pillows. I'll be doing a different design on each of them. I love this lace, so I just trimmed a length of it and glued it around the edges. Just wrap it around my pillow and tack down the edges with some hot glue. And then I have another 1 minute craft. I mean, not really 1 minute, but pretty much. So for the next one, I'll be doing a border of lace, and I'll be using hot glue for this one as well. The trickiest part is turning the corner, but even that's not very tricky in the scheme of simple crafts. It's the hardest part, but it's not hard. I just carry on turning the corners on this pillow and tacking it down as I go. To finish it off, I just fold the edge of the lace under, so it's like a mitered corner. There we go. And then I use some hot glue to tack that down as well. I trim off my excess and decided that the lace was a bit too large of a scale. So I cut the outermost edge off of the lace to make it a more dollhouse appropriate size. And that is my pillow done. So I have these pairs of pillows again. It only took a few minutes and they look lovely on my little sofa. So our tabletop looks good because of our books and the sofa looks good, but we got some naked windows. So I'm taking a toothpick and gluing my cheapest plastic bead to the end of the toothpick to act as a curtain finial and cut a piece of lace that already looks like a curtain. I'm using my sewing needle and gathering this. I did try to do this with hot glue, but it did not work. So I had to pull out the sewing needle. And it was easy and fast, so even I can cope with this amount of sewing. Once I had it all gathered, I glued it to my curtain rod. I'm making this curtain look like a circle skirt. I honestly don't know the correct terminology, but I'm just taking the cut ends and gluing them to the sides, and that's finished. This next one is even easier. I just cut a piece of lace that already looks like a blind hanging down and folded over the top with some hot glue, and that took 5 seconds. I don't know if anyone noticed the lace blanket hanging on the sofa at the beginning of the video, but here's how I did that. First things first, I want to protect the back of the sofa with some aluminum foil. And then I'll add a piece of cut up lace that I soaked in some watered down white glue. I'm using the pins to pin it in the shape I want on my sofa. Then naturally I used my hair dryer to speed up the drying because I'm impatient. And now we have a draped blanket for our sofa. Here I'll be using the same technique to dress up this sideboard. First I protect the top of the wood with some aluminum foil. And I smoothed it out. This probably wasn't necessary, but I was worried the wrinkles might show in the final result. I cut a length of lace and used my old trick with the watered down glue. I wanted this to look like it's draping over the side, so I just loosely held the ends down with some string, and then I dried it with a hair dryer. Once the watered down glue soaked fabric is dry, just remove the string and the aluminum foil, and there's a pretty lace runner for our little table. Oh look, a velvet box. And some books. That looks pretty. For the final project, I cut this circle out of a piece of lace, and I'm soaking it with my watered down glue concoction. I'm using these two bowls to make this lace into a bowl. There's more details about this in my video on making a hanging lace light fixture, so check that out. But what I did here was dry it within this little bowl sandwich, and when I pop it out, it holds the shape of a bowl. This looks pretty as it is, and you could make several of these. You could make like a little nesting bowl situation. I decided to paint it gold. It kind of looks like mustard on camera, but it looks better in real life. I'm using some hot glue and a glass spice jar to give it a flat bottom so it doesn't just topple over. And there's my bowl. Here's the simplest craft of them all. This is how I started this day of crafting. I just took some lace and cut out any little designs I thought might be useful and designs that look like doilies. These are the pieces I use to glue onto books. You can use these as doilies for a tabletop. I even used some museum tack to put some on the wall, and that looked really nice. There's really a whole host of things you could do with stuff like this. Take a look at ribbon and lace trim with a fresh eye. Like, this one looks like a cafe curtain just how it is. This one looks like a bed skirt to me. So I hope you've gotten some great ideas today. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss out on content. And I'll see you soon with a new video. Bye-bye.